Hello everyone and welcome to another video. Today in the 7th episode of Tech in Minutes, we are going to talk about VRAM. So what is the VRAM that everyone keeps talking about when buying their cool new graphics card? Well, VRAM is the short form of Video Random Access Memory, commonly referred as VRAM or video memory. VRAM stores all the information and data that your computer displays. It acts as a buffer between the CPU and the graphics card. When a picture is to be displayed on the screen, the image is first read by the processor and then it's written on the VRAM. The data is then converted by a digital to analog converter into analog signals that are sent to the display. This is when we see an image or a video in the monitor. This process occurs so quickly that we don't notice any flickering between frames. So how does the VRAM stop from flickering between two images, or why don't we see a black frame between the redrawing of images? It's because unlike normal RAM or memory, VRAM chips are dual ported. It means it can perform two tasks at the same time. While the display is reading from the VRAM to display the current displayed image, the processor is already writing a new image to the VRAM. So before finishing the draw or display of current image, the VRAM has new frames ready for the monitor. Due to being dual ported, the video memory is able to put up a frame and render a new frame at the same time. This is one of the reasons why we don't use RAM as video memory. Also, let's answer a common question about available VRAM in SLI or Crossfire configuration. Will I have 4GB of VRAM if I put two graphics cards of 2GB in SLI or Crossfire? Well, putting two GPUs with 2GB of VRAM in SLI or Crossfire will not result in 4GB of usable VRAM. You will only have 2GB of VRAM, which you could have anyway at the first place by putting a single graphics card. So now the question is, how much VRAM do I need for gaming? Well, there are no clear-cut answers. Modern titles have very high-quality textures and playing at high resolutions require a lot of data and pixels to render. Also, adding up anti-aliasing adds up to the VRAM usage quite a lot. These are the main things that influence VRAM usage. So for modern titles and the high-quality textures, I would say that 4GB would be the sweet spot for 1080p gaming at high settings. I have an in-depth video about how much VRAM do you really need for gaming. You can check that video out by clicking that eye icon. Also, if you find the video useful, make sure to give it a thumbs up, subscribe for future Tech in Minute videos, and I'll catch you in my next one.